Here, we are going to look at an interesting effect caused by refraction of light. And for that, we are going to start with this tank of water. It is filled up to here and then surrounded by air, of course. And we are going to place a coin at the bottom of this tank. Or you can imagine it is the aquarium at home. And then we are going to observe it from outside. For that, we will be taking rays coming from this coin. And the simplest of those would be one that is coming vertically up like this. Because this is vertical and all liquids, and water is no exception, have a horizontal surface, this happens to be normal to the surface. And all such rays are known to come out or cross from one medium to another undeviated. So it doesn't go left, doesn't go right, it just comes straight out. So if some observer is at this point, he or she is bound to see that coin somewhere on this line. But we don't know exactly where. For that, we need one more ray. So let's take that. Let's take another ray, say coming at an angle like this, and striking the air-water surface at this point. What happens next is best understood by doing a little geometric construction. And that is nothing but a normal drawn to the surface. Normal is basically a perpendicular. But because it is drawn to a surface, we call it a normal. And the laws of refraction say that whenever light crosses from a denser medium, optically denser medium like water, into an optically rarer medium like air, the ray deviates away from the normal. So instead of coming out straight like this, this ray is going to deviate towards left a bit. So let's draw that. So this is our ray coming out of the water and into the air. And you can see it has gone away from the normal. Then if there is an observer here, he or she is going to see that coin not at the bottom of the tank, but somewhere on this line. Because intuitively, our brain knows that light travels in a straight line. So it is going to conclude that since it says this light ray coming this way, it is somewhere here. So let us extend this ray backwards till it meets our first ray. And since the two are intersecting here, that is where the image of the coin will be formed. So this is where you will see the coin to be. The actual position is here at the bottom, but it will appear to be at a shallower depth than it actually is. These are the actual and apparent lengths. Now let's see how we can predict this distortion. Well, it depends upon the ability of the medium to bend light, and that is quantified as the refractive index. So let's start with Snell's law, that mu, refractive index, is equal to sine I upon sine r, the angle of incidence and angle of refraction. Let's mark those angles in this diagram. So let's get rid of these coins, and instead we are going to consider this as our incident ray and this as our refracted ray. Doesn't matter, light is reversible. That will make this angle as the angle I, and this will be the angle of refraction. Moreover, we have these two lines, one here and the normal ray here, which are normal to the same surface, and therefore they will be parallel to each other, and then these rays will become transversals of parallel lines. So we can mark some more angles which are going to be equal to angle of incidence and refraction. Now we can express this ratio of sine functions, approximately at least, as a ratio of tangent functions. And we can do that when the angles are small. So let us mark this length here. Since tangent function is opposite side upon adjacent side, the opposite side to I is this, adjacent side is the apparent length. While for R, the opposite side is same and the adjacent side is the actual depth. Now this opposite sides being same, they will cancel out, and therefore our formula will reduce to the ratio of actual depth to apparent depth. Finally, let us see how good this formula is, and for that we are going to take various positions of these rays, and we are going to start with positions close to the normal, and you can see the image of the coin is not moving much. So in this zone the formula is good. It will give you the correct value of mu if you are using it for that calculation. But if you go away from the normal, and as the angles are no more small, then you can see there is substantial change in this apparent depth, and then you'll get a wrong value of mu.